Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. And today we are here in Antwerp and we are here with Charlotte. And we are going to show you how to make lumpia saliwa or fresh spring rolls in English. So guys, let's get cooking. Lumpia saliwa is a Filipino dish which is made of different kinds of vegetables and also a vegetable crepe. But now we are in Baby Pinoy and Charlotte will show us how to make it in a Filipino Belgian way using a Belgian pancake, right? So Charlotte, can you show us what is the ingredients in making lumpia saliwa Baby Pinoy style?
Okay, very important, very important is garlic. So we need garlic. We have some onions, sweet potato, carrots, celery, green beans, and for the topping we have roasted peanuts and cilantro, and also freshly black ground pepper. And to cook everything we use some vegetable stock.
So are we gonna saute it and...
First we're gonna cook the vegetables.
Okay.
And we're gonna cook them in the pan. First fry everything with oil. And then cook them with vegetable stock. Because Filipinos like it with a lot of garlic. And then we just stir it till it gets a little bit brown. And then the oil gets the taste of the garlic.
That's always with Filipino food. We always use garlic, always. It's also our smell, I think.
Yeah.
It's a Filipino smell.
And then I already put in the onions. So they get a little bit glassy. I already put in the green beans first, because they need... Oh, not so much. I'm gonna add some sweet potato to there.
So with this kind of dishes, you can basically, guys, be creative of what vegetables you like and what vegetables you don't like.
And so also like how you cut the pieces, like the green beans, we put it like little, but you can keep them long.
Yeah, that's true.
And I add the carrots at the end, so they can keep their crunch a little bit.
Yeah.
We add a little bit of the vegetable stock.
And the vegetables.
And then you just have to let it simmer.
So okay guys, while the vegetables are simmering, we're gonna move on to make the pancake or the crepe. Usually lumpia saliwa is made out of fresh lumpia, which is the ingredients are cornstarch, flour and egg. But today, because we are in Belgium, they made it their own way by making a pancake and wrapping the vegetable with a pancake. So we will introduce her boyfriend to make us pancake the Belgian way, because it makes sense. Do you call it like a crepe or...?
Yeah, we just call it a pancake.
Just pancake. Yeah. And in Dutch it's pannenkoeken, right?
Pannenkoeken, yeah.
Here we have a little bit of melted butter mixed with a little bit of olive oil. We have one egg, a little bit of normal flour, and we have full milk. So, we're gonna start off with the melted butter and olive oil.
You gotta make sure the butter is not still warm, because otherwise it will already cook the egg. So you need it to let it cool for a bit. Then we're gonna...
So guys, all the written recipe will be linked down below, and visit www.sesskitchen.com and all my social media for the recipe of their pancake and also their lumpia saliwa.
Yeah, okay, so we add the egg. Then we're gonna add little hints of flour along the way.
So bit by bit?
Yeah, bit by bit, not too much.
So if you start noticing the dough getting sticky on the edges, you're doing a good job. Maybe just a little more.
Now we have the dough. It looks like this when you stir it. It's like really, really chewy.
Okay. Oh yeah.
So that's good. Then we add.
Look, guys.
Yeah,
you want that. Nice, that's sexy.
Sensual.
Yeah. So a sensual pancake.
Yes.
Okay. Made with love.
So then we start adding little hints of full milk.
It's also, guys, it's not on one go as well.
And it's gonna take a while for the milk to soak in the dough. You add just a pinch of salt to the batter. Normally for the Dutch pancake,
yeah,
it's sugar.
But yes,
we don't want a
sugar.
Yeah, we don't want a sweet pancake because we already have sweet potatoes.
Yes,
yeah, that's why.
That makes sense.
Okay. So now the batter is ready.
It's better to have a pancake pan.
Yeah.
How do you say this in Dutch?
Een pannenkoekenpan.
Pannenkoekenpan, pancake pan in English.
Yeah. Okay. So we're gonna add a little bit of sunflower oil.
You don't use butter? You
no.
Can. Oh, okay.
Yeah, you can use butter, but
what's the difference?
Because there's already olive oil and butter in the dough,
okay,
it will be less sticky to the pan.
Okay.
But
oh,
we use just
okay,
like a little bit, and we turn it around the edges so it will get loose when we cook it. Okay, then we're gonna add the batter to the pancake.
One scoop?
Yeah, maybe a bit more.
So how many minutes we're gonna wait till we flip it over?
Okay, you're gonna have to wait till you start noticing they have like
the
a little crooked, little cooked.
The edge starts to
okay,
cook like brown.
But you still
brown
have like dough in the middle.
Oh, okay.
If you're gonna flip it now, the dough will spatter all over yourself.
So how do you do it? You just like flip it like that,
yeah,
or you need to?
Maybe if you use a little bit of sunflower oil in the pan, you're able to flip it over.
Okay.
You don't need a spatula.
Ooh.
You see this?
Oh.
And then
maybe
we're gonna
do an exhibition. Ooh. Yes. That's a good one. Oh, so guys, the pancake is ready. Cook. And then we're gonna paint it up, and then how do you call it? You're gonna incorporate all the ingredients in a pancake. So, lupian sariwa, you need to be to make sure that you have a sauce. It's always have a sauce. And what you made a sauce for the, usually it's a peanut sauce.
Yeah.
So what kind of sauce did you make? What's the ingredients?
These are the ingredients of a sweet and sour Filipino sauce, which is made with rice vinegar,
yeah,
and soy sauce.
Okay.
And also cane sugar.
Okay.
And garlic.
Did you put, to make it thicken? Yeah, lots of garlic. And to make it thicken, you put cornstarch on it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Also to
yeah,
thicken the sauce. So now, as Charlotte, we're gonna show you how to plate up the lumpiang sariwa.
So for the lumpiang sariwa, we use this little gem. It's a really cute one. Put it here, and then you just. Don't get it too full. And then you top it with some roasted peanuts. A little bit of cilantro.
That's coriander in Europe.
Yeah. And the sweet and sour sauce. And you can just like how you adjust it.
So guys, our lumpiang sariwa is already assembled. And we were gonna, it's plate up, so we were gonna taste it. So this is a vegetarian option. This is good for vegetarians. So if you want to have some bacon or shrimp or whatever, it's up to you. And we're gonna taste it. We're gonna get a spoon and spoon because we don't use fork and knife. So we're gonna get a spoon and fork to taste this, and we will let you know how does it taste. I think I need a knife. No,
I thought you wanted a spoon.
Yeah, I know.
You get what you ask.
Yeah, exactly. That's the quote for the day. Guys, this is really good. The combination of the crunchy peanut, the roasted peanut, the combination of the sauce, the garlic sauce she made, the cilantro, and then the pancake, for me, is a complete revelation. Thank you, Charlotte, for accommodating me here in Antwerp. And if you happen to come, if you happen to be here in Antwerp, please come pass by and come and eat here in Baby Pinoy. All the details will be written down below. And the recipe will also be at www.seskitchen.com. And If you're still here, please don't forget to subscribe and give me a thumbs up if you like this recipe video, because I will always make you food that makes you feel good. Bye! Joy!
No banging on it.
No, I'm not banging on it, okay. I'm holding it.
Sure.
Can you get on? Where's And guys, I will always make you feel good. I will shit, I don't need to.